Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to On the Mic with Mike. It's the premier social enterprise business show here in RVA. I'm your host, Mike King, and I appreciate you being here with me because, frankly, you could be anywhere else doing almost anything. So join me as this cutting-edge show uplifts the community and showcases RVA business in a different way. So we're coming to you live and direct from downtown booming Chester, that hotbed of business activity. Every deadline, it kills every time. People just love it. So this show highlights partnerships, innovation, social enterprise, nonprofits with business people and organizations making a difference in the greater community, the greater Richmond area. So please follow my main brand, which is Mike King Biz. We'd like to thank our show sponsor, Jimmy Comer and Chris Smith of Community First and RBI Services. So they're providing some excellent services to the financial world for nonprofits. Shout out to those guys, Chris and Jimmy, doing some outstanding work. Also, shout out to the Ford Foundation and all the work that those guys do. So here we are, folks. Things are a little different in our world these days. So normally I'm saying to you, Mike King, coming to you from WNTW, 92.7 FM, 820 AM, but not anymore. So in these changing times, business has been sold. The radio station has been sold. So I'm coming to you live and direct from Facebook. We will have an announcement of our new home shortly. I will keep you guys informed. So the program, as usual, we try and bring you the best of the information here. Shout out to all the folks on the commemoration of Juneteenth. We had some folks who were going to give us a call in and tell us a little bit about what was going on, but the assets were so great here, they bought the phone system. So the number that our friends have called before, we don't have that number anymore. So please keep up with our business, which is Mike King Biz. So joining on today's show is informative, engaging, and filled with community game changers. Folks, this is the program. We bring everything from Abigail Spamberger to the tarot card reader, and we always have everything in between with the business aspect of how business can help society be better. On today's show, we have Brian Anderson, CEO of Chamber RVA, Art Espy, serial entrepreneur, Todd Feldman of The Rocket Factory. We also, since this is a program to help you from a holistic standpoint, we have Blue Matchmaking as well, who's going to come on a little later, talking about the business of love and matchmaking. This show.
So what are people really tuning in for today? Is it us or the matchmaker?
Or the matchmaker.
They would have said, hey, get those guys on here. And let's get on with it.
Let's get to the love.
It's inexpensive warm-up act.
Exactly. So this is the warm-up act. We will have
the headliner comes up later.
Shit, that's true. So, you know, from the media bit, we're calling that bearing the lead. So, fellas, I'd just like to thank you guys for coming in. I appreciate you coming in. So, over all of this, what really has turned into is a shout out to Garrett Westlake. And I had seen this thing called Spark Champ. And since it's a business show, I contacted Garrett and said, hey, I need to be a part of that. Let me figure out how can I help you guys? And he said, hey, you know, contact Todd over at Rocket Factory. But prior to that, with Art Espy, we were talking, and he says, hey, I got this thing coming up. It's called Spark Jam. Then I have Brian Anderson on. I see that. I'm like, okay, so the Chamber's involved. So obviously, clearly, gentlemen, this is the place to be as far as that goes. So, Brian, we'll start with you. Could you give us an idea of, from a business standpoint, before we get to Spark Jam, the business world, what it looked like pre-COVID? What are your members talking to you about? And how are they navigating this coming out of the change?
Well, Mike, thank you for letting me be here, and more importantly, for being with these distinguished colleagues to talk about good stuff and what you do in the world of keeping us all up to date. It's really a tale of two worlds. You know, pre-March 5th or 15th, whatever date you pick, we were in full employment. The economy was, you know, doing everything we thought it would do. Finding people to fill critical jobs was the biggest challenge. You know, retailers were doing well. Restaurants were doing well. Big business in the stock market doing well. And then, boom, a devastating pandemic hits. We all have to do appropriately what did happen, and we had to stop, you know, figure out what's happening, talk to our medical experts, talk to our doctors, and be sure that we can manage this. And that's really what it is, managing, because every day was new information. So as we first said, it was a health pandemic that we had to deal with from a health perspective that turned into an economic travesty that we've all been dealing with lately. So we're now coming out of it. Thankfully, we've seen around the country that governors and local leaders are reopening. It's a different scale everywhere. And that reopening has been, again, a mixed result. It's been everything from some kind of going very fast. Georgia, the state I came from, opened up pretty quickly, to us in Virginia being a little more slow. But it, nonetheless, the numbers have been backing the fact that those two processes are okay. There are some spikes. Those are being dealt with. But overall in Virginia, from a pandemic standpoint, we never got into a really hard decision with our hospitals. We had good capacity all throughout. PPE, personal protective equipment, was up and down as far as being a problem or being available. We think we've got a handle on that. And now businesses are trying to make sure that as we reopen, whether you're a restaurant or a business like my office, that we do so safely and responsibly. So initial feedback is, as restaurants opened up their patios, as they started to open up on the inside, as other businesses allowed a limited amount of economic activity, the news is pretty good in the sense that people are coming back. They seem to have confidence. You see lines at places like Joann's Fabrics to Target. You see people at restaurants again. So we're hopeful that this delayed but planned process for reopening is helping. But we also know from everything from national data, recently had Tom Barkin on our webinar talking about from the Fed's perspective, that this will be a long recovery. It will not come back as fast as it went down, obviously, but it also shows that we do have the resiliency. The economy was sound going into this, so it ought to be able to recover once we continue to get our handle on the pandemic, which means getting a vaccine and more treatment protocol.
So, ladies and gentlemen, the voice you're listening to is Brian Anderson, CEO of the Chamber RVA. So, Brian, when have you really seen a difference between, say, the bigger businesses, more established, and the smaller entrepreneurs who are out there really trying to struggle, or has the problem sort of been across the board?
It's affected everyone, but obviously the bigger you are, the better financed you were, the more resilient your business were, you've probably managed this better than some. It's been devastating to small business. When you close your business for 8 weeks, and that's what most of them did, physically close the doors, it's very difficult to manage that. Most small business owners are putting their own personal capital. They may have some money they borrowed from family members or the bank. They don't have large reserves to get through. Their job is to service their clients, take care of their employees, and maybe make a little profit at the end of the year. So unless they had huge reserves, it's been devastating for them to reopen. So we've had all kind of programs from cities and counties. We've got large companies putting money into funds. How do we help small businesses, giving them $2,000 grants to $10,000 grants? But that's where the need is the most. Most large companies were affected, but they certainly can open back up a lot easier than some of our small businesses.
So when you look at what's going forward, when do you think that the economy for the small business in the Richmond area will sort of bounce back, not to what it was before, but getting acclimated to the new normal?
Yeah.
So I guess the summer's kind of a touchy period. No one's really sure. You know, for businesses are pushing, I've been part of a couple of Facebook groups, Chamber, the one is Reopen RVA. Yep. It's been a little different, you know, and they're saying, okay, we need to open quicker. Other people are like, no, we're doing it at the right pace. When we look at everything, do you think that people will sort of get their footing in the fall? And what's the Chamber's plans? Are you guys doing anything different, say, when the fall rolls around?
Well, let me just say briefly, because there's a lot to cover. We created, working with 40 other organizations, this Forward RVA reopening plan. And the reason was, we couldn't do it all on our own. We couldn't, you know, small chambers couldn't do it on their own. So we said, let's all partner. We raised about $200,000. We bought personal protective equipment, marketing material. We gave them guidelines for reopening. And we made physical toolkits we gave to over 2,000 businesses. Two reasons for that. The first was, the business owner needs a shot in the arm. They need to feel like people care. Secondly, they've got to be able to open in a way that their employees first and then their customers feel safe to come back. If we just open up the doors and nobody saw face mask or sanitizer, it would have been a catastrophe. But so far, businesses have done what I've seen them do most of the time. They've been responsible. They've done the right things. They've been caring for their employees, and now they're caring for their customers. So it's going to take time. There are some businesses in Richmond that said, I'm not ready to open, and that's their prerogative. Business owners should have the right to make the decision what's best for them. And we said that from day one. But as it rolls out and rolls through the region, we are seeing some good signs that people are doing it right and people are coming back, which is a good sign.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we have to go to break right now. My grandkids need stuff. So, you know, and we got to pay bills around here. So we'll be back shortly with the gentleman on the panel. Thank you.
Awesome.
Fresh Berries and Treats is Richmond's new best-kept secret, but now the secret is out. Nestled in the city's newest social corner, Scott's Edition, we feature homemade desserts and sweet treats to satisfy any craving. Everything is made from scratch and fresh daily right here in our kitchen, located at 1726 C Altamont Avenue. Come by and check us out. We also offer vegan options, custom cakes, and event and corporate catering. Try us out, and remember, life is sweet with Lush Berries and Treats.
Before and after the salon has been active in the Richmond, Virginia community, providing hairstyling services for over 10 years. Before and After is located in downtown Richmond at 1917 West Carey Street. Specializing in weaves, extensions, and growing healthy hair, Before and After provides a full suite of hair care services. Expert stylists Michelle Smith and Alicia Clark are well trained to meet your styling needs at Before and After the salon.
Did you know embroidery is an easy, low-cost way to market your business? Let Godmama Wear LLC assist you with your custom logo embroidery needs. Whether you need shirts, hats, or yoga mats, Godmama Wear can embroider various items. Visit us online at www.godmamawear.com. That's www.godmamawear.com. Let's talk soon.
They say the two happiest days of a boat owner's life are the day he buys his boat.
Woohoo!
And the day he sells it.
Sayonara, you worthless tub.
At Carefree Boat Club, there's a third happy day, the day he joins the club. Carefree Boat Club gives all the...
Woohoo!
Without the hassles that turn a day on the water into a real pain in the...
As soon as it turns over, we'll be on our way.
At Carefree Boat Club, use a fleet of boats as often as you like. They take care of the maintenance. You take care of the fun. Water skiing to fishing, whatever floats your boat, Carefree Boat Club's got you covered. It's like owning a fleet of boats with none of the worries. Whether you own a boat or have just dreamed of it, come sample the experience of being a Carefree Boat Club member. Call today to schedule a tour of one of Carefree's convenient marina locations. Make all your boating experiences...
Woo-hoo!
Water skiing to fishing, whatever floats your boat, Carefree Boat Club's got you covered. It's like owning a fleet of boats with none of the worries.
866-630-5959. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. It's the premier social enterprise business show here in Richmond area. In studio with us today, we have Brian Anderson, Todd Feldman, and Art Espy, talking business and all things that are relevant as far as business goes in the Richmond area. Next up, we're going to talk to Art Espy, serial entrepreneur. All three of these gentlemen are involved in something that I find very interesting, and it's tied back to our friend Garrett Westlake over at the Da Vinci Center, who was here a couple weeks ago. So, Art, the floor is yours, sir. You have a book that's out.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Mike, and I'm glad to be on the panel with these guys talking.
He said it's a panel. You know, on the mic with Mike. On the mic with Mike. We've graduated. I have a panel. Sorry.
With this group of guys free-winging it on, freestyling it on small business. We have a new book that just came out from our group. It's in one of our series, a Misfit Champion Sustainable Business Series. And the latest book is Making Your Business Thrive in a Recession. One of the things that's really important and that we all have to be mindful of is that the recent changes that have happened, COVID and everything that's going on in our society, has really given us a huge wake-up call to the importance of small business to the economy. And that's really what Spark Jam is bringing to light, assistance for those small businesses and problem solving. It's what our new book, Making Your Business Thrive in a Recession, is really focused on, helping you make prudent decisions in chaotic times, and really going back to the people, process, profit kind of key things for a small business. And if you're a small business, slide profit out and let's call it cash flow, which is what Brian was alluding to. If you're not a big business and don't have a stockpile of cash or a rich granddad or Mike, you know, if you're one of Mike's grandkids or rich granddad, then you either have to depend on your bank or your revenues to take care of your business and take care of your customers and take care of your employees. What we're really seeing now is the importance of all of that and the number of jobs that small businesses provide. So to all you small business people out there, hats off to you. You know, we've got support for big businesses. We've got support for middle market businesses. We've got support for startups. You always hear about startups and entrepreneurs, but we've talked very little about the importance of small business to our, not only our local economy, but I would dare say to our national economy as well. And I think that being with these group of guys, free winging it, freestyling it, talking about that today is very important for everyone to hear and acknowledge and to maybe get a tip or two about how to help your small business do a little bit better in today's chaotic times.
One of the things that we talk about here and what I see is how businesses pivot. So we had the SBA regional administrator, he came on. So at first, you know, PPP was the thing. It was great. You know, money was gone. Okay, that's fine. Next round, they're trying to give the money away now. And so it's funny when you look at, so now we're partnering with SBA, and what they see is every day they're coming out with something else. You know, the business owner right now, he knows and the lady knows what they know. Mm-hmm. And that's what, so now all of a sudden you've had to introduce a number of other things to them. How do I survive? And now here's the government saying, we got money, but we scared you guys all so bad that no one wants to take it anymore. And so they're out there saying, hey, you know, we have this money to help you survive. And what can we do to help you? So what you're talking about, whether it's cash flow or partnerships and all of that, I think it's very important. And that's why I'm glad that you guys are here to talk about how business is interacting with society. How can business make society better? Being that it's Juneteenth, and this sort of has a technical aspect to it. So when Lincoln freed the slaves, it took 2 years before the people got the word in Texas. 2 years. I mean, so now it's funny. So when I was a kid, when something broke into the news, you knew something important had happened, but you had to wait to get that. We live in a time now where it's just constant information. And as a business owner, how do you survive getting that information, and how do you process it? And then how do you take it and make it relevant for you, what your business is doing? And that's what you're talking about there.
Yeah, so one of the things that as a small business owner or a small business leader, one of the things, you don't have the luxury of time in a lot of cases to make decisions. And you're so focused on your small business and making money, making your revenue, making payroll, that you don't have the ability sometimes to look at the bigger picture. So I would caution you to respond rather than react. And so take a step back, look at your business, look at where you want it to go. From today, we've been in the COVID environment for 3 months plus. So no matter what business you have, your business has been impacted by it. Whether you had to do curbside delivery, go totally online, no matter what, your business has been totally impacted. What lessons do you want to take from what you've learned over the last 3 months into the future of your business? What partners are out there that can help you do that? And that may be totally different than how you looked at your business in December of last year, January of this year, before COVID hit. But tying that back to Juneteenth, let's look at it as a freedom of thought, freedom of being open-minded to new possibilities for your business.
Okay. So we have these two gentlemen here. The voice was Art Espy, serial entrepreneur, a man who has, so you went to the Coast, no?
So I'm a graduate of the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy. I served as a navigator on cargo ships for a while, and I was an officer in the Marine Corps, in the United States Marine Corps.
So, okay.
Thank you, service.
So here we go. We've been talking to them, and you guys are here. And there's this thing out there that's creating a lot of buzz. It's the word on the street. It is the thing that's happening called Spark Jam. And it's put up by this group called Rocket Factory. And the first thing I said is, who's Rocket Factory? Todd Feldman, the man behind the idea, the driving force behind Rocket Factory, is here. And he's going to give us an idea of what Spark Jam is. And so it's an educational piece tied to the community with the business sector behind it. And the two gentlemen here are part of it, which I didn't know until just yesterday. This whole thing came about that these guys were going to be here. And it all had to do with Spark Jam that I didn't know about. We were here to talk. I was here to talk to Art about something different. Brian was just here talking about the things with the chamber. I had no clue. So, Todd, the floor is yours. Give us an idea of Rocket Factory, and then explain to our listeners what Spark Jam is.
Well, I had the Rocket Factory is a strategic marketing company that launched literally at the doorstep of COVID. So
great timing. Like
yes,
said, yes,
yes, that's exactly that's how I feel about it. But, you know, so as my the revenue generation portion of my business started to take a little hit, I realized that there's still an opportunity to help. And I think for any business out there to understand what their mission is, why they exist in the first place, is critical. And so for me, it was like, I'm here to help startup businesses, small, middle, and maturing companies, high growth organizations, succeed. But in this case, from a marketing perspective, it's a little bit challenging because they're turning themselves internally and trying to figure out, you know, how are they going to survive? So for me, it was, okay, how do I open the doors to say, I want to try to take on advisory calls at no cost. Just let me hear, let me help you and share knowledge. And then from there, it also allowed me to create more content. So, and then be able to give, like, extend myself to a greater audience that way. So, always about brand building for any organization. For me, I was just practicing what I preach for my clients. And so, as we went forward, I was also realizing that the startup ecosystem was hurting. Was there a fund out there that would support the startup ecosystem? And there was not. And I wasn't in a position to start a fund. And I found the Virginia 30-Day Fund, mm-hmm. Which has been founded by Pete Snyder out of Charlottesville, who is providing $3,000 forgivable loans to small businesses. And all he asks is if they can give it back, then he can pay it forward to another business. And so he's doing fantastic work. I forget now the number. It's going up literally every day of how many loans he's given out. It's well over 350 loans. He spins them up within, I think, 3 days and gets them in the hands of small business.
I had put that out, and the people that I had sent that to were just shocked. They were,
it's amazing.
It's like, okay, explain this to me. And so, because it was something, I hear a lot of things, and people hear a lot of things that are out there helping. I'd never heard of that, and a number of people. And so it's different when you go to people, all the people in the same industry. But when you go to people across different industries, and everyone's like, wow, that's a great thing. I've never heard of it. So that one right there, for the people on the ground, small business, there's not a lot of red tape tied to it. You don't have to do that.
I think it's a video submission, and then they evaluate the request. And I mean, there's a lot of fine work being done, providing grants and other things. I think you all have them as well. And so they were just another one that we found and thought that would be a really good, you know, as we had the bones of an idea, and at the time we didn't even have a name. So it's just the bones of an idea. And then I ran into Dr. Westlake, Garrett Westlake at VCU, Da Vinci Center. And he's like, you know, what if we could, and it was, you know, you have this immediate simpatico moment with a person. It's like, what if, and in 10 minutes, it was like, what if we could do innovation around the needs of small business? I'm like, that's fantastic. And so this whole idea of an innovation challenge where we bring the head, hands, and heart of our entrepreneurial students of Virginia to Main Street, to small business, and apply their knowledge and thinking to solve, we can't solve individual business challenges, but can we solve sectors of business challenges and bring potentially technology or some other solution to market? So what we've been doing, and it's ending Monday, you can submit your video if you're a small business owner. You can submit your challenge, what you're experiencing within the kind of post-COVID reopen, and then also just thinking about yourself going forward long-term, like, how is my business going to change? And it's, you should be thinking about how it's going to change, because it is changing. And what challenges are you facing, and then what can those innovation students in Virginia, and we're talking about not just VCU, but Virginia Tech, William & Mary, Old Dominion University, Norfolk State, there's five of them. What can they do to help? And that during the day, and so that brings us to our event on June 26th. That's next Friday. So there's a couple things. First of all, get your videos in this weekend.
Or, and you could also submit by text, like through an essay. So okay. If you don't want to film a video, it's no big deal. And by the way, the video doesn't have to be Star Wars. It can just be a, like,
telling the story.
Just tell us your story and get it in, because we want to help. But there, you can write an essay as well online. And by the way, you can do that by going to sparkjam.therocketfactory.net. That's okay. The main site for everything.
So this is the shameless plug part of the program here. Tell us about Rocket Factory and what you guys do.
The Rocket Factory is a strategic marketing company. Thank you. Yeah, and we help businesses grow, and so thus the rockets.
The rocket.
Yeah. So we want to create, you know, the companies that we work with, and I have a history of in marketing helping drive some pretty significant growth for the organizations that I've worked for. I want to do that for a lot of businesses, not just working for one. So I felt the need and felt the desire to want to help many. And so that's what the Rocket Factory is all about. And we've got something really just for everybody.
So the Spark Jam idea came about, and you've turned that around and made that an event in how long?
It's about a month. You know, it was a twinkle in my eye maybe 6 weeks ago, and it took me a minute to figure out the piece about which fund and how I'm, you know, how can we give back. And so, you know, got on board with Elevation Advertising. I mentioned VCU, Activation Capital, and Profit Optics as sort of the made possible PIE partners. I couldn't have stood this up without their support very early on. And then quickly met Brian and was introduced to him and said, I need help getting the word out. He's like, we'll help you get the word out. I need panelists. I need people to speak. I need good content. And we got art. So next Friday, 8 a.m., we have Spark Jam 2020, which is this day-long event. And it really is a day of problem-solving, knowledge-sharing, community input involvement. You know, it's a webinar online, so it's all digital. You don't have to go anywhere but your home through Zoom. And we want to hear the voices from the community as well as we're talking, and there's panels going on. We'll be welcoming comment and other thoughts on how to solve problems. So
plus we need to sell some tickets too, don't we?
We do need to sell tickets.
Okay,
so
ladies and gentlemen, we need to sell tickets now, you know. This stuff ain't free. Well, you know, we need some help here to get the community.
Yeah, and the proceeds go to, so all the proceeds for the tickets, it's $10.
Oh.
So we're really trying to give you a pretty value packed day. $10 to attend for an all-day pass. We certainly want to encourage. There's an opportunity also to give a little extra. I think we call that like the extra spark.
Okay.
And you can contribute to by buying a pass, and then those dollars are going to the Virginia 30-Day Fund. Excited to say we've got representation from the small business community, and we're talking about like restaurant owners. We got a restaurant joining us from Northern Virginia. Portofino restaurant, Perch here in Richmond is going to be on one of the panels. We've got the startup ecosystem represented. We've got the tourism, you know, Virginia Tourism, Richmond Tourism, Virginia Hospitality and Restaurant Group is being represented. So, and then just as of this morning, just before I got here, we're almost there in finalizing what the music lineup's going to look like, because the live arts community in Richmond, and actually in Virginia, has been hammered by the, you know, they can't have live performances.
Right.
So how are they innovating around this time? So we're gonna hear music, and we're gonna hear from industry experts through the state, professors, concert promoters, and they're gonna talk. And so we're gonna have kind of interspersed panel discussion as well as music performances. At least that's what we're planning as of right now.
Cool. So, ladies and gentlemen, the time is 1:40. The program is On the Mic with Mike. It's the premier social enterprise business show here in Virginia. So we got to go away and take a break. That voice was Todd Feldman of the Rocket Factory and talking about Spark Jam. We're going to tie it up when we come back. The gentlemen who are here are part of that. And plus, we do have the matchmaker who's on the way. So that's just letting folks know what's going to happen. So, folks, we'll be back shortly.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jimmy Stump with Stump's Pig and Pint. We're located on the corner of 2nd Street and 119 East Lee. We specialize in slow-cooked meats, handmade sides, and homemade desserts. Stop by. Let us take great care of you. You can find us on Facebook at Stump's Pick and Pint, or you can give us a call, 804-477-3208. We look forward to taking care of you soon.
A Premier Bank home equity line of credit can open many doors for you. The door to a brand new kitchen, or the door to a shiny new car or SUV. Maybe the door to a college education for your kids. No matter what doors you want to open, Premier Bank can help with great rates and money to lend to qualified borrowers. Call or visit your nearest Premier Bank office to learn more. Premier Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Subject to credit approval and qualifying credit score. Premier Bank.
Hey, this is your chef, Michelle Wilson of Ma Michelle's Cafe, located at 10811 Hull Street Road, Midlothian, Virginia. Our number, 804-912-1644. Come and join us. We have live entertainment, a new menu. Follow us on Facebook at Ma Michelle's Cafe, Twitter, and Instagram. We are Seoul, south of the James.
Thank you, attorneys Justin Lauder and Chris Gatewood at Threshold Counsel PC for sponsoring this program. They offer startup, business, and intellectual property services for innovative and growing organizations. You can find them online at threshold.cc.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. We were supposed to have a friend of the program, Katina Moss, who she's an educator from down in the Hopewell area. She does a lot of work. So Katina Moss and Associates is her company. She was going to give us a call, but from the problem with logistics, she couldn't be here with us. And I wanted to let you know what they have going on. So it's Juneteenth 2020 down in Hopewell. Our friends down in Hopewell are doing some phenomenal work down there, and the program likes to support what they have going on. So it is Saturday, June 20th, 3 p.m. You can find her at K Moss Presents on Instagram, Facebook. Some of the folks who are going to be down there, so they're going to have an open mic team, and they're going to have Terrence Doctor is going to be involved. I see Ricky Reese Jr., Katina Moss, Sedona New. We just like to say, if you're down in Hopewell area, make sure you follow them and check them out. They're really doing some great things and super proud of the folks down there. We do have a special place here for our folks in Hopewell. So K Moss Presents, it's special performances by Hopewell Youth, and it's sponsored by the City of Hopewell with one of the most dynamic mayors. Shout out to Mayor Jasmine Gore for the great work that she's doing out in Hopewell. She's a young mayor, trying to make things right, being a civil servant, and shout out to her. So, back with the panel here, folks. I'd just like to say thank you for the guys coming in. So the underlying event has been, with the collaboration of you guys, is Spark Jam. So Brian, give us a little bit of an idea of when the idea came to you, and they're saying, here comes, you get a lot of things coming to you. I mean, you're the big dog here. And so it's like, get the chamber on board. They can help.
Who did I make the check to?
Exactly. Don't tell my wife you gave it to me. I just take cash. So explain what it meant when they came to you and said, hey, we have this thing called Spark Jam, and we'd like you guys to be involved.
Well, Todd's a good salesman. Obviously, that's why he does his job like he does. But in all seriousness, and listening to Art talk about the fact that you can never help small businesses too much. Even as we consider a large regional chamber, 50+%, like 59% of our membership are businesses of 50 employees or less. Mm-hmm. So given that, you got to help those folks because, again, they don't have large bank accounts. They're making it, and they're keeping their families employed. So when Todd called, I said, anything we can do, we don't have a lot to offer because we're a not-for-profit business, but we want to help with our voice, and that's one thing we do have that we can do, and I hope that it's going to work out. And then the second part, again, as Art says, when I hear ideas like this, there's some things, you're right, we get asked a lot of things, doesn't fit our lane, but if it's pro-business, and it's to help people create wealth and employ their employees in a better way, we're going to be all for it. So we were happy to do what we can. I hope this will be a regular event. You know, we're involved in a lot of other programs. We're talking right now about how we can do more in the minority business accelerator space. Mm-hmm. Big need, because again, there's a lot of people doing a lot of little things. Mm-hmm. We need to scale that. How do we help a business that's got $1 million in revenue and doesn't realize how they can go to the next,
right,
the rocket idea? How do we get them to $2 million? Right. And so hopefully you'll see very soon a lot of people coming together, a lot of organizations, how we can do that better, make connections where I may be, again, $1 million in revenue, a masonry company, and I get small jobs. How do I get on a big project like a VCU might do, or working with big companies around here building big buildings? So that was why the idea, and we're happy to do anything to help small business.
One of the things to go back to, like you say, the minority business part of it, it's something. So after one of the protests, I went downtown. A friend of mine has a program. It's called the Good Road TV, and they do it. So it's Craig Martin. He does a thing. We're looking at philanthropy for on a worldwide scale, business and people doing great things. And so I was coming, and I went down to VMFA to be on his show. And when I looked around, what I noticed was, even in the midst of all of that, all of the businesses that were there working were all white. Mm-hmm. And even in the middle of all of that, and then it kind of struck me that, I'm sure somewhere that there was a minority business that got a contract. And they were happy to get the $15 contract because it beat nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But there were $100 contracts that they didn't know anything about. What have you seen during this pandemic? And this is a little off topic, but what have you seen during this pandemic area as far as minority businesses go, reaching out to the chamber for help?
Well, again, we've got a reputation, one that's good in most regards, but we're also considered a big business, big chamber, sometimes considered too white, too Caucasian. So we've got some branding work to do as an organization. But secondly, I would tell you that they're asking anybody they can for help, because again, it's such a pervasive need right now. So what I'd say is that we've learned through this process a couple of things. You mentioned the PPP program from the SBA program, the EIDL, the Emergency Injury Disaster Loan Program through SBA. Through both of those, we found out many minority businesses, whether it be female-led or African-American-led or Hispanic-led, they didn't have a formal banking relationship. So they were already behind the eight ball, if you will, and had to catch up. So we want to do things like, through this conversation, is, again, you may be running a wonderful business, but you don't realize how important it is to have a banking partner. Do that. Secondly, you may have legal issues you don't know how to handle. So rather than having to go hire a firm that you don't know how much it's going to cost, we want to get them started with a law firm that will say, what is your legal issue? How do we help you? Third could be insurance bonding. I may be having all the talent and employees to do a job, but I can't provide the surety bond of $1 million to get into the project.
Right.
We're going to help find ways to do that. And then the last one would be accounting. You know, how do I manage my books in a way that sets me up? Cash flow is king. It can't just be at the end of the week, I got $10 left over, like I lived a lot of my life. It's got to be, I got $10 or $100. What do I do with that to get me better prepared for next week? So those are ways we can help, and whether it's COVID related or not, how do you help a small business go from point A to point B? And then the other part I'd say is, you know, wealth creation. You can work for a big company. I came from Coca-Cola and Budweiser, great big companies. I worked there my whole life, and I will retire fairly well off. I won't be rich, but well off. But if I started my own business today and I do it well and I work hard, I can retire very wealthy. But we got to help people realize how to do that. So that's all of this tied together, is how you help small businesses create wealth for themselves and their family, because it's not they're going to be buying yachts. They're going to be taking care of their children and their grandchildren, and it becomes multi-generational. So that's the impact that I'm looking at, is how we can help. We do just fine working with the Capital Ones, the Altrias. They're great companies, and they do a lot. But we want to help that small business person with a good idea and a good work ethic get to the next level.
Okay. So, folks, that's one of the reasons why that I think Spark Jam is so important. Mm-hmm. So, Art. When I go down the list of people on the panelists, I see Art Espy.
Mm-hmm.
What are you going to be there talking? So you have an interest in the tiny homes as well. Too. That's one of the smaller structures. Mm-hmm. You are a Renaissance man. That's for sure. So what are you going to be at Spark Jam talking about?
So what we're going to be talking about is really how to use this chaos that we have, this crisis that we've gone through, to your advantage. And how to as Todd and I were talking when we first decided to come together on this, how to make that bounce, to bring
you
to come back and make your business not only as strong as it was, but stronger and better, and make it sustainable over the long term. And one of the things, I think what Brian was just alluding to and how the Chamber's working with small businesses is really helping small businesses move from a hustle mindset to setting up systems. It's somewhat easy, relatively easy for a small business contractor to hustle their way up to $500,000, $750,000 in sales. But you hit a point, an inflection point, where if you don't have the right systems in place, the right relationships in place, you are not going to go beyond that. It's just a impossibility of business physics. You're just not going to go beyond that.
When you talk about that, that is truly something. So, you know, the work hard, hustling thing, people get that. And in bad times, people always find a way to hustle. They don't worry about that when times are good. But people start hustling. And like you said, you hustle, hustle, hustle. Then you get to the point where you're doing pretty good. You're hustling out there, but you can only get to that
you
level.
Can only get so far.
Because you don't know, you're too busy
how
doing
do
the things that you do.
Yeah.
How do you scale that? Yeah. And when I look at Richmond as a home for entrepreneurs and startups, like in Lighthouse, the scaling, you know, what are the businesses? It's good, and you can take care of yourself, but how do you scale it? Or the ones that start up Virginia, you know, the idea. Most of them won't work, boy, but you know the ones that will, because everybody else has that hustling thing. Mm-hmm. I'm going to work 99 hours this week, and then next week I got $10 left, and I'm like, fine. And but you say, how do I make that $10 work better for me? Mm-hmm. But I've been hustling. So you're talking about processes and systems in place to help you get to that next level.
So one of the companies I was involved in several years ago, I remember going through a mindset shift, and this was a fairly larger small business. So we're going from, I think we did like 14, 15 million in sales. And we were trying to figure out how to get north of 25 million, which is a huge, huge, huge mindset shift for a small business owner, small business leader. We went through the same type of learning curve and awakening, enlightenment, if you will, going north of 50 million. Now, those are much bigger numbers than what are typical in a lot of the small businesses, but it's the same mindset that in some of the earlier stage businesses I was involved in, going from, to be quite honest, 75,000 to 250,000 in revenue. It was the very same mindset.
Yeah.
So we all have to be aware that there's certain things that what gets us to a certain level is great, but it might not be enough to get us to the next level. And we have to be open-minded enough and not locked into our way of doing things enough. And this pandemic is a perfect time to use that as an excuse to make the change and set our egos aside and learn ways to push forward and develop the relationships to push forward. Because this pandemic has created an opportunity for everyone to create new relationships. People are much more willing to talk now than they were November of last year, August of last year, when they couldn't keep up with business because the economy was growing so much.
And Mike, I would add to what Art just said is the other part, the COVID pandemic was part one. We shut the world down. Mm-hmm. So we all had time to kind of take a breath and look at things differently. Now we've got a social pandemic going on in the sense that mm-hmm. we're challenging each other correctly, I might add, to think differently and do life differently. What better time to also say, we've always wanted to help all people move up. Small business is a direct path. I can go work for, again, a company all day long. I might get promotions and all. But if I can help a young man or woman that wants to be an electrical company owner, they're electricians now. They're going to hire 10 other electricians. Now they own their own company or an HVAC company. That's the fastest path to wealth creation. Mm-hmm. And it's not because they can go buy yachts. So they can have a good home. They can educate their children differently. They also can help their employees better. They can give back to organizations, charity organizations, that they're not doing at the $100,000 revenue level. So all of this ties to what you said earlier. How do you build a better society? Business has a big role in that. But we don't always accept that, or we don't always push ourselves to do both. And I think this moment in time, we're saying, that ain't right. Look at all the ads being run now. They all have a corporate social responsibility mm-hmm. message, and rightly so. Let's don't let this be a moment in time and we go back to what's the best brand? How do you sell more Coca-Cola? Let it be about how do we help humankind better? And I think we got a real opportunity here. I'm excited. I'm frustrated by the fact it took tragedies. But let's make sure we don't let these bad things go not be the motivation to look in our own selves about how we do better.
I think I tell people for all the problems that we see on the news, and by being in the Army for a long time and living in a lot of places, worldwide, people wake up every day and say, I'm going to go to America because mm-hmm. I can find my way and I can do great things. Mm-hmm. Americans wake up every day and say, you know what, I'll go on vacation there. Mm-hmm. And then I'll come back here because the power of the people. And also, so my big thing here is our partnerships, bringing people in here who may not know each other, who have different backgrounds. Mm-hmm. How can we make society a better place? What part does business play? And like you said, we had one pandemic, right, followed by another one. Now, the COVID one may go away. There may be a vaccination fairly soon, and then, okay, that goes away. This other thing right here, when you start looking at the crowds and they're like, that crowd looks different, that's not just a bunch of all the same kind of people upset. Mm-hmm. So how are we going to take that energy and that movement and go? So here you have all the schools who are in SparkChamp. Right. And for me, it's good because there's an HBCU, because that makes a difference, because the students there want to get involved in the program, want to get involved with society, making place, you know, because there's a lot of white Americans who don't understand what an HBCU is, why it's big for Norfolk State to be there, because it makes a difference. Richmond has a really big entrepreneurial spirit, the startup community is strong, and when you go to Lighthouse, you see a bunch of people, all different kinds of people who have that idea of starting a business. So here we have three businessmen here talking about business, and one of the underlying things is business can make society better. So we have a bunch of students. People always knock the educational world, like, oh, that's not the way business is done. You guys are open up, and shout out to Dr. Westlake.
Yes.
But this one right here, because it says, tell us your problems. And, you know, because all business people think that they, you know, my business is totally different than anyone else. No, it's not. You got some of the same problems. And so these universities are coming up with an idea and a way to go about helping. So shout out to you guys for putting it together. A couple more times, let us know about SparkJam, the particulars for it. Oh, shout out. So our love doctor is lost. I just wanted to give an update.
Okay. All right.
I'm in shock, folks. That's real-time information there. I'm not so good that I just read something and just continue on. That one stopped me in my tracks. So let folks know about SparkJam again.
So right now between now and Monday, get your ideas in. And so go to sparkjam.therocketfactory.net. And if you hit on the submit your video or submit your challenge, you'll be able to write an essay or submit a video. And again, it does not have to be well produced, just talking to the camera and tell us what's going on. And then those university students will be taking those ideas and trying to come up with some solutions on the day. Tickets are on sale right now. All proceeds for the ticket sales go to the Virginia 30-Day Fund, which is directly for small business. Those are $10. And again, if you go to sparkjam.therocketfactory.net, you can buy tickets. And of course, if you would like to contribute a little extra spark, that would be great as well. And then the other piece is the day, which is June 26th. I don't know why I have February on my brain. June 26th, starting at 8 a.m. It's going to go all day. You can come in and out. We certainly don't expect everybody to sit with us for 8 hours, but if you want to, we certainly would love to have you. You're on at what time? 3?
3:30.
3 o'clock. So that was Art saying he's going to be on at 3, talking about the bounce. And again, the day is meant to be I talk about it's not about we're going to solve everybody's problem, but can we be that spark? Mm-hmm. Can we help people go forward with a new sense of purpose and energy? And it all relates to everything that's going on socially, business-wise, building relationships. You know, so just want to have a good, some good feels that come from the day, and certainly some good energy that comes from the day. Again, June 26th, 8 a.m., sparkjam.therocketfactory.net. Buy tickets, make contributions to the Virginia 30-Day Fund. All proceeds go to them.
Good enough. All right, Espy, name of your book, that's a wrap-up, and how can people find you?
Making Your Business Thrive in a Recession. It's under our Misfit Champion Sustainable Business Series, and we'll put a link to where you can purchase the book in the show notes. It's available on Amazon. It's probably the easiest way to find it.
All righty. Brian, last word for the chamber.
Colleen, that says, remember, all big businesses were once small businesses, so we need to help make sure we continue to spark businesses to get them open, because that's just going to grow. Secondly, I'd say that, you know, as we looked at what Art said a while ago about, even from a business standpoint, we're challenging people. Don't just think what you want to go back to pre-COVID. Reimagine what you want to be. And that's society, too. That's, we don't want Richmond to be what it was on March 1st or February 28th or whatever date you pick. We want to reimagine what our region can be, what our city can be, and also, if you're a business owner, what your business can be. If we do that, we'll all get better expectations and results.
All righty, folks, the time is 2:02. We're going to go away, pay a couple of bills. We'll be back shortly. Thanks now.
Hey, this is your chef, Michelle Wilson of Ma Michelle's Cafe, located at 10811 Home Street Road, Midlothian, Virginia. Our number, 804-912-1644. Come and join us. We have live entertainment, a new menu. Follow us on Facebook at Ma Michelle's Cafe, Twitter, and Instagram. We are Seoul, south of the James.
They say the two happiest days of a boat owner's life are the day he buys his boat.
Woohoo!
And the day he sells it.
Sayonara, you worthless tub.
At Carefree Boat Club, there's a third happy day, the day he joins the club. Carefree Boat Club gives all the...
Woohoo!
Without the hassles that turn a day on the water into a real pain in the...
As soon as it turns over, we'll be on our way.
At Carefree Boat Club, use a fleet of boats as often as you like. They take care of the maintenance. You take care of the fun. Water skiing to fishing, whatever floats your boat, Carefree Boat Club's got you covered. It's like owning a fleet of boats with none of the worries. Whether you own a boat or have just dreamed of it, come sample the experience of being a Carefree Boat Club member. Call today to schedule a tour of one of Carefree's convenient marina locations. Make all your boating experiences...
Woo-hoo!
Water skiing to fishing, whatever floats your boat, Carefree Boat Club's got you covered. It's like owning a fleet of boats with none of the worries.
866-630-5959.
A Premier Bank home equity line of credit can open many doors for you. The door to a brand new kitchen, or the door to a shiny new car or SUV. Maybe the door to a college education for your kids. No matter what doors you want to open, Premier Bank can help with great rates and money to lend to qualified borrowers. Call or visit your nearest Premier Bank office to learn more. Premier Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Subject to credit approval and qualifying credit score.
Premier Bank.
This is Sean Nicholson with SMN Square Incorporated, providing the building blocks for success and sustainability in your business. We currently own and operate a co-working executive office and training facility called The Hub, helping you in business, located in Midlothian, Virginia, inside the Victorian Square Shopping Center. For more about us and what we do, please log on to www.smnsquare.com. That's smnsquare.com. Or you can find us on all social media platforms, SMN Square.
Did you know embroidery is an easy, low-cost way to market your business? Let Godmama Wear LLC assist you with your custom logo embroidery needs. Whether you need shirts, hats, or yoga mats, Godmama Wear can embroider various items. Visit us online at www.godmamaware.com. That's www.godmamaware.com. Let's talk soon.
Before and after the salon has been active in the Richmond, Virginia community, providing hairstyling services for over 10 years. Before and After is located in downtown Richmond at 1917 West Carey Street. Specializing in weaves, extensions, and growing healthy hair, Before and After provides a full suite of hair care services. Expert stylists Michelle Smith and Alicia Clark are well-trained to meet your styling needs at Before and After the salon.
Starting a business can be exciting, but did you know you need business insurance? Have you started a business and aren't sure if you have the right coverages? The Insurance Lady Consulting Firm makes sure we educate our clients on the products and services needed to protect your brand, contracts, and your clients. To better serve you, our firm offers tailored coverages and a variety of business consultations. We are a small woman and minority insurance firm that offers professional and general liability, commercial auto, workman's compensation, and much more. Call us today at 888-784-9980 and follow us on Instagram and Facebook as The Insurance Lady, L-A-D-I.
Hello, everybody. This is Vinny Jones from Enzo Cigar Lounge, the new premier cigar experience in the Richmond area. We're conveniently located at 9101 Midlothian Turnpike, Suite 800A, inside the shops of the Arboretum. Come by for something different. We have a great selection with a knowledgeable staff to help you out. You can reach us on Instagram at Enzo Cigars, on Facebook, Enzo Cigar Lounge, Twitter at Enzo Cigars, and also our website, EnzoCigarLounge.com, to find out about special promotions and events. If you come in and mention On the Mic with Mike, I'll give you a 20% discount. Thank you very much. See you soon.
Sandra Wilson, CEO of Black Connections. Black Connections is an all...
Yeah, this is Big Herm from Big Herm's Kitchen and Catering. We're located on the heart of Jackson Ward on 315 North 2nd Street, Richmond, Virginia. We're open Monday through Friday, 11 to 6, takeout and delivery, but we also cater anytime. We deliver all types and cater all types of events from graduations to weddings. Please check us out at BigHermsCatering.com or call us directly, 804-922-3693, for any of your catering needs.
Thank you, attorneys Justin Lauder and Chris Gatewood at Threshold Counsel PC for sponsoring this program. They offer startup, business, and intellectual property services for innovative and growing organizations. You can find them online at threshold.cc.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. I'm Mike King. Just like to thank our esteemed panel who was here, Art Espy, Brian Anderson from the Chamber, as well as Todd Feldman from Spark Jam. I'd like to thank them, gentlemen, for coming in and talking to us about that event. So, folks, make sure you go in and check out Spark Jam, as well as for our businesses that are out there. It's the Virginia 30-Day Fund. Take a look at that. That information will be up on my Facebook page, the Facebook page for the show On the Mic with Mike. As we wrap things up, I'd just like to say shout out to my wife and all the caregivers who are out there keeping everything together. Shout out to the folks and congratulations for Juneteenth. And like I said, once again, I'd like to make sure folks know about the Juneteenth 2020 down in Hopewell. K-Moss presents. So it's a special performance by Hopewell Youth and sponsored by the City of Hopewell. So shout out to them. I'd just like to say thanks to Community First and RBA Services, Jimmy Comer and Chris Smith, for sponsoring On the Mic with Mike. We also had Focus Floors. If you ever need any flooring done, make sure you take a look at Focus Floors, who were the sponsors for our Game Changer segment. So with that, like to thank everyone for tuning in. We will see you later. So On the Mic with Mike, we're moving, and I will be letting everyone know where we're going to very exciting times. I'd like to say we made the station so popular, people came in and bought the station. So shout out to my partners who were with me on the Success Radio team. That's Sharon Oliver, Nicole Reed, Shirley Crawford, and Michelle Wilson of Mama Michelle's Cafe. Shout out to them. Shout out to everybody who supports. Make sure if you want any information about me and what I do, MikeKingBiz.com is it. I'd like to thank my man Austin for being on the Wheels of Steel and helping out. So with that being said, folks, take care of each other. Happy Juneteenth, and we'll see you next week. Then thanks. Now take care.